I like. Have you ever been rebuked before? I have. And I tell you something, Jesus looked at those storms and he rebuked those storms and told them to be still. Stupid storms, be still. And those storms listened to what he had to say. And, you know, he just constantly was taking authority over anything that had gotten out of control. Oh, I love to just open up the Word of God and begin to read it and think about it and chew on it. Whoa! And swallow it. Oh, and strength comes into my being and just gives me the get up and get with the program attitude to go on and believe those things. How dare those situations in life try to stop me? God said, set your forehead like flint against your enemies. If you cow down, I'll confound them before you. But if you set your forehead like flint, Exodus 23, he says, I will drive out your enemies before you as you increase in strength. Isn't that something? God the land. Sometimes my children, I've got four of them, sometimes my children, and my wife's got five, sometimes my children, we got four kids, I was counting myself as one of the other ones, but sometimes my children, they're willing, but not very. If you be Christ, then are you Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. Just sing that little song. I am blessed. I am blessed. Every day that I live, I am blessed. When I wake up in the morning or I lay my head to rest, I am blessed. I am blessed. Say it with me. Sing it with me. And I'm not saying I'm a singer, but I sure love to make a joyful noise. I make a lot of noise and it's joyful. I am blessed. I am blessed. Oh, every day that I live, I am blessed. When I wake up in the morning or I lay my head to rest, I am blessed. I am blessed. 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 Defined means to be empowered to prosper.
That's not man's doctrine, that's the Bible. And that's what I'm here to do. Just most folks have never eaten manna from heaven before, and they don't know what it is. Chew it. Eat it. It gives you strength to rise up and do things you couldn't normally do. Come here, I'm going to lay my hands on. I don't know who you are. We're going to follow God today. We're going to obey God right now. Just got 7 minutes. What a number, seven. Seven. I just believe there's substance and act on God's word. That's why I'm a firm believer in this vow. Because you know something? I know I can scream and holler and rant and rave on TV all day long, but until you do something, it's not going to do a bit of good. Hello! I know until I get you involved in the word of God, hallelujah, that scripture right there will begin to produce in your life. You'll never be broke again. I said you'll never be broke again. It says, in the day of trouble, I'll hear your prayer and deliver thee. Job 22 says, acquaint thyself now with him, and you will store up gold as the stones of Ophir and silver as the rocks in the brook. Yea, and thou shalt make thy prayer to him, and you'll be able to pay your vows and decree a thing, and it'll be established unto thee, and the light will shine upon thy path, glory to God. That's Bible. That's new wine. That's manna from heaven. They never eaten it before. They didn't know what to do with it, but they started eating it. Ooh, they fell in love with it. That's what Elijah, a little widow, began to eat, supernatural bread. Say, where'd you get that, Mary? Where'd you get that, John? Boy, that tastes good. Where'd you get that new chair? How'd you get that new car? How did you get that joy? How'd you get that peace? How'd that door open for you? You know somebody, don't you? Yes, I know somebody. Where he leads me, I will follow. Where he leads me, I will go. Will you? Abraham had to put his best gift on the altar before God could bless his socks off. Jacob had to, and as you help him, Oda, my son, you have chosen to look beyond your own means and to look to my riches and glory. Yes, you chose to make a vow of faith toward me, believing that I would help you in the day of your troubles, and I will meet thy needs, not according to your riches, but according to mine, because you dared to believe and be a doer of my word and not a hearer only. Though the storms may rage around you, your house will not fall, because you heard my word this day and you chose to be a doer of it. So rejoice, oh rejoice, for the showers of blessings are coming. Rejoice today, for doors that were closed will begin to open before you. For you have chosen to believe my prophets, the word that I speak through them this day. So rejoice, for the day of miracles has begun in thy life. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I almost wish I was Lottie. Here's Tom. What time? Minute before we go off the air. If you're going to call, you need to call right now. I break this curse of poverty off this child of God. Satan, you're bound, you foul devils of hell. You gates of hell, you're shut. I shut the gates of hell in the name of Jesus. And now by the word of God, to step out of the old lethargy, tradition, doubt and unbelief, and religious programming of carnal reasoning, instead of supernatural Holy Ghost mind of God. That Bible's the mind of God. And when you take that promise and you take that scripture, that's a miracle working scripture. That's God. That's Jesus. He's the Word. And if you'll act on that scripture, it has to bring miracles into your life. And I happen to believe that. And I bet my life on it. And if you got problems, I've got the faith of God right now to break that curse and those gates of hell, to shut the gates of hell in your life. But you're going to have to do something. You've got to make a vow of faith, just like the Bible says. I saw that. The vow of faith gets people into faith and God starts moving. See, I know He moves. Would you call me right now? Make a $1,000 vow and we'll send you a return envelope and a prayer that have seemed to have been shut for you, saith the Lord. For I have given my...